Hi, FTFam. Today we're going to be looking at tips to fix your lag, reduce your input delays on ping. This tip will improve your overall gameplay experience. If your players feels twice as heavy when you're left stick dribbling, then this video will fix that for you. Let's get started.
By a promising looking attack.
So the first thing we want to do is actually optimize our game. Now what we need to do is put our game in the performance mode. To do that, you need to go to your settings and go to your save data and game app settings, and from there you go to your game presets, and then you see the performance mode or resolution mode, and you simply just change it to performance mode. This means we're asking our console to prioritize performance over graphics, and this is actually going to mean a lot of things in our gameplay experience. Now the second thing we need to do now is to make sure that our internet connection is via Ethernet cable. Now this is an example of what an Ethernet cable looks like. I know everybody is into Wi-Fi nowadays, but Wi-Fi is not as efficient as the Ethernet cable, so use the Ethernet cable if you want to play on the online mode. Another tip for internet is you need to do a bit of research on the available internet service provider in your area and just go with the one you can afford and actually seems like a very good option. We need to optimize the EAFC24 itself. Now you do this by going to settings, and in the settings you go to the settings, game settings, and you come to the visual tab. Here you're going to turn off some things that you do not really need and actually create a bit of overload when you're playing online. The first thing you need to turn off is the playstyle's overhead indicators. You do not need that, and this is actually going to create a bit of lag when you're playing online, especially if your internet is not as strong. It's advisable you turn this off. Now also you have to come to down and come to this hypermotion insight overlays. We need this turned off also. This also had a bit of lag to our gameplay with it turned off because the game is always looking out for it, I guess. But turning this off has significant impact on your gameplay experience, so it's advisable you turn this off also. So the next tip now will be to optimize our matchmaking settings. To do that, we'll just simply go back by pressing O, then we'll go back again and we'll come to the online settings. You're going to see matchmaking options down here. Now, if you are in a location where there are a lot of players online, then you should set this on. This approximate location matchmaking means you're going to be getting matched to people within the same vicinity as you. And as a result of that, your input data doesn't have to travel over long distance on the server and your response is much more better this way. But unfortunately, some of us are in locations where there are not a lot of FC24 players around, so I leave mine turned off so I could get more pool of players I can play with. But if you're in a good location with a lot of players around, it's advisable you turn this to yes. Now, the crossplay settings is actually another interesting topic. Now, crossplay means you are going to be matched with people on PC, Xbox, different consoles, and different game engines, game machines. So if you turn this to yes, it means you're telling EA to match you with anybody as long as the person is playing FC24. But if you turn this to no, it means you're going to be only playing people on PS5, on your similar console. I have a PS5. So it means I'm only going to be getting matched to people that are on PS5. This settings is actually of another significant impact. But unfortunately, in my location, there are not a lot of players, so I turned this to yes, so I could get more pool of players. But ideally, if I'm in a location where a lot of people are playing online, I would set this to no, because this automatically means information exchange is smoother, and as a result of that, your gameplay experience is way better. Without even sugarcoating it, in order to get rid of the input lag, you need to have a very good internet connection. That is why it's important for you to do your research on the best ISP in your location. You need to connect your internet router to your console with Ethernet cable and not Wi-Fi. You need to keep your controllers charged at all times to maximum capacity. If you cannot do this, it's best you use a USB cable to connect your controller to the console. And most importantly, and this is what all the pros use, get a gaming monitor with faster response. An ordinary TV is fine, but with a game monitor, you get at least 20 to 50 ms gain, depending on the kind of screen you're using. Before, a faster gaming monitor would offer you a response time of 1 to 5 ms, which is the best. Most TVs out there is doing probably doing 50 ms to 100 ms. Those are still lags and it could count in competitive mode.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe.